Welcome to April 18th, 2020. What happened today in COVID history? Let's see, shall we? This article made the rounds. I think most people remember this. This was a surprise to a lot of people. Not to me. Nearly a third of 200 blood samples taken in Chelsea show exposure to coronavirus. Anybody who understands natural immunity understands this or understood this. The way this was received was extremely problematic. People were surprised. People didn't know what it meant. And when you explained to them what it meant, they refused to believe what it meant. Obviously, what it is, if you are a halfway thinking, rational person, this is the fact that this thing had blown through here. We know now it was here in the fall of 2019. A ton of people have caught this thing and got better. A ton of people caught this thing, had no symptoms. 80% of people that catch COVID don't have symptoms. 15% have super mild symptoms. The rest are the ones we have to worry about. But the good news is, when you get the virus, if you catch it naturally, you get immunity. You do. It's natural immunity. It's better than vaccine immunity. I'm sorry, the vaccines are great, right? Yay, science. But natural immunity is broader, stronger, longer. You get antibodies, you get T cells, you get all sorts of stuff your body does that learns from this. It's very powerful. Is it perfect? Of course not. Nothing's perfect. But this means that even the small sample size, and it's funny because they weren't doing this a lot. It was almost like we didn't want to know. It was almost like this is the kind of testing that we should have been doing, right? You know, testing, everybody test, you know. We jumped in with the wrong tests. Can't handle the tests. These antibody tests, these blood sample tests, these are the kinds of tests that a lot of very smart scientists were demanding that we do, and they weren't listened to. We do this in other times. We test the water supply. And again, we've done this retroactively. This is how we now know that coronavirus was in the United States as early as, I think, September of 2019, because they looked at blood bank donations from that time. They can see these specific COVID-19 antibodies in there. Again, this is a good thing. And once again, we take a good thing, we take good news, and we either ignore it or we sort of twist it into bad news. And we can't have good news. We could never have good news. Good news was not allowed. And that was a huge part of our issue. It continues to be a huge part of our issue. And shame on us for that. Again, this was great news and we just ignored it.